Hi guys, my name is Byfair from RFN, welcome to Inside Destiny for the 11th of May. Coming up on the show, we have big news, as this week Bungie has officially let slip that the beta is coming in July. Activision additionally is going to invest $500 million in Destiny over its development. The mailsack has some intriguing faction details, and Destiny Overwatch has some faction wallpapers. All this and more, don't go anywhere. So, what do we know about the Destiny beta? Well, let's take a look. Firstly, we realized that the beta had been moved back when the Destiny release date had been pushed to the 9th of September, when originally it was going to release sometime this spring. There was going to be a beta originally in spring as well, however that got pushed back as well to summer so that Bungie could work on the game longer. So, what is the aftermath of this? Well, we've just been waiting longer and longer. Pre-alpha builds, of course, have gone out of the game, and Guardian Radio got to play some of those. Go ahead and check them out. Streams every Monday night. But on top of that, we have some intriguing detail around everything from these new sources of information. And the first one that I really want to pick up on is this article here from Game Informer. And this is intriguing because the CEO of Activision, Eric Hirschberg, on May 6th at 3:57, stated that the beta would be in July. So what's weird about this is that Bungie's official Twitter then posts that the Destiny beta will indeed be in July, something like 3 hours later. And all of a sudden this makes me realize, could it have been that this is a detail that Eric Hirschberger let slip? Were we meant to know about this? Who knows? And here's another intriguing question, could the beta drop on the 7th of July, aka Bungie Day? I think not, and the reason why is because we may already be playing it. Look at this question from the mailsack. Deej's response to can we expect big things for Bungie Day is, sure, the entire Bungie community can enjoy it. What does that mean? Well, really, it means good things. First of all, everyone who has an Xbox One and feels left out with this kind of stuff is going to be happy because, well, frankly, they've been cut out of a lot of stuff, and the beta is going to be the largest thing that they miss out on. But not only that, we've also got fantastic news for them that if it is something inclusive on Bungie Day, they may be getting it sooner than they thought. This could give us an indication that if the beta starts in July, perhaps it starts for PS4 on July 1st. Perhaps then 3 days of access time is given exclusively to PS4 and the beta is released for Xbox One users as well. What does this lead us to? Well, everybody could be playing the beta on July 7th, and that could mean that Bungie could be doing some special things with us in the beta. Alternatively, it's most definitely going to be releasing afterwards. One of those two possibilities. But in the meantime, if you want to know more to the beta, look out for the series I'm going to be starting soon known as Bife's Guide to the Destiny Beta. Yes, I am indeed going to be doing this, and it's going to be a thing, and it's going to be glorious. And I'm going to tell you everything that we know about it. And the best ways to survive Destiny, no matter where you are, what class you play, or how you think you should be doing it, I'm going to help you guys out. So yeah, look around for that series. I really want to go ahead and start that, and it's going to be something big, I hope. In the meantime, though, beta news is going to be continuously rolling in, and the more that we know about it, well, the better. But until then, we'll have to wait until E3 of this year, which is when the majority of the news that we have left about it is going to be announced. So yeah, I guess we have to wait until the summer drop of June 8th. So, next up, Activision is investing $500 million in Destiny's marketing and development. What? That's madness! To give you an idea of how big that is, the previous record holder for this was GTA 5 by Take-Two Interactive, and their publishers basically gave them $260 million. Rockstar, of course, this is, who developed the game. Now, I want to put that into context. That's a lot of money. That is the GDP of some countries. This is more money going into Destiny over its marketing development than you get out of third world countries, many third world countries combined. This is enough money to feed, like, the starving populations of several countries for a year. This is absurd. This is actually ridiculous. What do you guys think of this? Because this boggles my mind. Some people say that it's not going to return as much, but Activision are pretty confident. They've said they want this to be their third multi-billion dollar franchise. So, yeah, will we see this joining the likes of World of Warcraft and Call of Duty? Who knows? But $500 million is a hell of a figure. So, I hold some personal confidence with this, but I don't blame you guys for not doing it, because, to be quite frank, this isn't just a bet, this is a gamble. So, next up we have the mailsack, which is dedicated to Craig Hardgrove because of his expertise and his knowledge of, well, Destiny's rocks. No, I'm not kidding. I really am not kidding. Allow me to let that sentence sink in for a bit, and if you want to know more about Hard Rocks of Hardgrove, tune into Guardian Radio every Monday night. In the meantime, we have real questions and real stuff we want to know about. HaloMonster95 starts off with, just to reassure many of us, you love all your fans the same, no matter what system they play on, right? Deej says that's right. You have some tough choices to make about the vessel you'll select to transport you to the world of Destiny. No matter how things end up, Bungie will love you and will play with you. That's cool. Really cool. What this means, of course, is that Bungie is going to be having playdates and play nights with every single console. And that doesn't just mean Xbox One and PlayStation 4, it also means last-gen consoles. So look out for the PS3 and Xbox 360 game nights just as much. They do love their Bungie guys, no matter what system they play on. So in the meantime, Paragon asks, how much time in advance will we know about the beta? Will it be like the day before, or will we know, say, a week or two in advance? And of course, Deej responds with what we already know. You will know well in advance. For starters, you might have heard it will happen in July. You'll discover more about exactly when it comes and when it is your turn to play Destiny's beta at E3. So basically, wait till E3. Nothing we're getting teased out of Deej here. And then again, that's nothing unusual. And we already sort of knew about this. This question is really to affirm from earlier that the news drop is completely legitimate, even though this did come from Bungie's Twitter as much as it came from Game Informer. So next up, we have Sephera with question, dynamic skyboxes? Deej is like, hell yeah! The sun rises, the sun also sets. It happens in real time, right before your eyes, assuming you have a quiet moment away from the bloodthirsty invaders to drink in the scenery. So that's cool. Nice sunrises and sunsets for those who love the scenery. And Monkey D, what can we be expecting as far as multiplayer? Well. Multiplayer will never be in the case of the real world, so you'll never get multiplayer being encountered in patrol mode. And Deej basically tells us that whilst your fire team can't be interrupted, you can go in and multiplayer will be separate. More at E3 on that. And Chucky J begins the tirade of faction questions with, do factions even exist? It's weird that I bought a new Monarchy shirt 2 years ago and I'm still not confirmed that it actually exists. And to this, Deej basically just says, don't use the shirt to spit shiny shoes just yet. They are a real thing, and we will be taking more questions on it. Having said that, he also tells us that Guardians are free agents. You'll be able to decide whose bidding is worth doing, and you can be an equal opportunities killer as well. So all of these factions allow you to kill for different reasons and different motivations. Something we already knew, but still, it's interesting because of this thing that it adds to Destiny's world called lore and depth. Tetragon, next up, asks this, you said we will learn more about PvP at E3. Does this also mean we'll get more information about the factions since they are integral to PvP lore? And to this, Deej responds, your assumptions seem to root factions in the competitive arena. In truth, each faction will have their own motivations for sending you out into the wild on a variety of vital missions. They're not just cheering sections for a competitive fracas. You'll find their agents in the tower. You'll discover their missions while you're patrolling the wastes. You'll detect their influence over other heroes of the city. Everything you do in the game will add to your understanding of the story and the world in which it takes place. Factions are the colorful strands in that tapestry. So the factions are integral to story as well, which is nice to see. The Clawman! Will my whole clan... Yes, his entire clan. For a minute I read that as the Clan Man. Will my entire clan need to be in the same faction? And to this, Deej responds, no, you'll have a number of ways to express your solidarity with one faction or another. Or none at all, or all of them. One thing we do not want to do is give you a choice that would result in a barrier between you and your friends. Your clan is quite safe from the sectarian strife of the factions. Be excellent to each other. In other words, this is pragmatic. Factions add wonderful story little tidbits to the game, but it's not as though you all have to be in the same thing. Clans are things of your own creation, not something that Bungie can force upon you. Next up, Tegulant Prefect asks, will there be any faction-specific gear like weapons and armor? And he says, factions will reward you for your service to their cause in a number of ways. You just mentioned two of them. And to this, he basically highlights a bunch of Guardians with some faction-specific gear, such as the new Monarchy pistol you can see right there. Then he highlights the previous Conduit F3 drawing board, which of course has the future Warcult logo emblazoned on it. On top of that, you can see all sorts of gear that's very specific to these factions throughout the Devil's Lair strike. So go ahead and look out, see if you can spot any other weapons that may be faction-related. Having said that, that's it for the mail sack, guys. Nothing more I can say about this here. Next up on the community focus, we have the wonderful Destiny Overwatch aka Martin giving us a great look at what we can do with factions and banners. In particular, I want to highlight that these are now wallpapers, and you can find all of these on destinybungie.org. Go ahead, follow the link, also give Martin a subscription on YouTube, because you know what, he's also another great Destiny content creator, and he's another part of this wonderful Destiny community that we've come to know and love. I don't know about you guys, but personally I think I'm going to be going Seven Seraphs with this. It's a faction that I have a lot of identity with, and I just love the way that they look. Plus it's to do with the number 7 because Bungie, and Angels because Bungie. Why wouldn't you? In the meantime, guys, please do remember, go ahead and like me if you're over on Facebook. I do have an RFN page set up. Also like this video and subscribe to RFN on YouTube so you can get all of my content pertaining to the Destiny world and so you can eventually catch up with Bife's Guide to the Destiny Beta. Also follow me on Twitter at InsideDestiny so that you can hear all of my ramblings and Destiny news shower that I will give you from time to time. And in the meantime, guys, my name is Bean, my name is Bife. I'm a man of many names, but all of them come in peace. Paradasia Rastra. I'll see you, Starside.